Good morning, children. How are you? How have you been? How was your week? Have you been well? Great. Are you happy this morning? If you're happy and you know it, clap your hands. If you're happy and you know it, clap your hands. If you're happy and you know and you really want to show, if you're happy and you know, clap your hands. If you're happy and you know, say amen. Amen. If you're happy and you know, say amen. Amen. If you're happy and you know and you really want to show, if you're happy and you know, say amen. Amen. If you're happy and you know, stamp your feet. If you're happy and you know, stamp your feet. If you're happy and you know, and you surely want to show, if you're happy and you know, stamp your feet. Wonderful! I hope you sang with me. Hamjaniwacha hivyo peke yangu. Great! Do you remember what we learned last week? We learned about loving one another. And God has given us another time and another week to learn brand new things. And today, we want to learn about helping one another. Or in another way, accepting help from other people. Have you ever been given some work that you found very hard to do? Maybe somebody told you, carry that chair. And you struggled. And you struggled to carry the chair. You struggled to carry the chair. And then you asked your friend to help you, or you asked mom to help you, or teacher gave you some homework. And while you were seated at home doing the homework, something was very, very hard, and you could not do that sum. What did you do? You asked dad or mom or auntie, please help me with this one. I do not know. All right? That is what we shall be looking at today. But before we continue, let us pray. Hands together, we are praying. Father, in Jesus' name, we want to say thank you for giving us yet another week, another opportunity to be here to learn from your word. So, Lord, help us to understand and to put it into practice. In Jesus' name, we pray. Amen. So, great. Welcome back. The one who didn't carry their Bible, please go and bring your Bible. Go and also bring your notebook and your pen or pencil, and let us learn. And as you go to take your Bible, your notebook, or your pencil, we go with this song. I'm happy today, so happy. In Jesus' name, I'm happy because he has taken away my sins away. I am happy, so happy today. I'm happy today, so happy. In Jesus' name, I'm happy because he has taken away my sins away. I'm happy, so happy today. And the place to be happy is here. And the time to be happy is now. And the way to be happy is to make someone happy and to have a little heaven down here. And the way to be happy is to make someone happy and to have a little heaven down here. Great! Now I hope you are seated with your pen, with your notebook, and with your Bible. Alright? Now, in the Bible, we learn so many places, and we shall look at three verses that tell us that we should be able to help other people and also to accept their help. One time, in the book of Acts, a man called Paul, that time his name was Saul, he was on his way to Damascus to persecute the Christians. He said, these people cannot be spreading bad news. They cannot be telling lies that somebody resurrected. So he got letters from the high priest and the officials of the temple in Jerusalem to go and look for those people who are believing in Jesus Christ and kill them. So he went, and he was going to a city called Damascus, and off he went, riding on his horse, going to look for the Christians, saying these people cannot continue to say somebody resurrected. And then suddenly, just before he got into Damascus, a bright light shone on him, and he fell down from his horse. And then a sound from heaven said, Saul, Saul, why do you persecute me? And he said, who are you, Lord? And Jesus told him, I am Jesus whom you persecute. And then from there, he was taken into a house and he stayed there very angry because his eyes had also lost their ability to see. He was now blind and he was there very sad and not accepting to see anyone. That is the kind of situation that sometimes we are in. When we are told to pick up something very heavy, oh, and we are unable to, and we don't want help because we said, I can do it. I can take this seat all the way there. And then you are unable to. And so God told him, somebody will come to see you. And when he comes, you allow him to pray for you. And when that man came to see Saul, he prayed and Saul received his sight back. Isn't that a wonderful story from the Bible? Now, when we come to today, in those situations where we are unable to do the things that we must do or we should do, we have to accept some help. In Hebrews chapter 13, verse 16, it says, do not forget to do good and to help one another, because these are the sacrifices that please God. Now, the Bible tells us to not forget to do good and to help one another. To do what? To help one another. That also means when we are in trouble, we should allow others to also help us. When I'm unable to carry something very heavy, oh, it is so heavy, I should tell someone, please come and help me to carry, and they help me and we get to do the work that we've been given. When I am doing a sum or when I am doing my homework and it is very hard and I wonder, what is the answer here? How do I do this multiplication? How do I do this one? How do I color this? When I do not know how to do it, I ask someone else for help. And also it means when I find someone else struggling to do it, I tell them, do you need some help? Do you need some help? And there we get to help one another. So that nobody, none of us is stuck. Nobody is unable to do the work that they were given. Again, in Philippians chapter 2, verse 4, it says, and look out for one another's interests, and always considering others better than yourselves. Two verses. One was in Hebrews chapter 13 and verse 16. And now Philippians chapter 2 and verse 4. And finally, another verse. It is in Galatians chapter 6 and verse. Let's find it. Galatians chapter 6 and verse 2. Galatians chapter 6 and verse 2. And it says, help to carry one another's burden. In this way, you will obey the law of Christ. One more time. Help to carry one another's burden. In this way, you will obey the law of Christ. Three wonderful verses. Hebrews chapter 13, verse 16. Philippians chapter 2 and verse 4. And Galatians chapter 6 and verse 2. And all of them are asking us to help each other out. To be the one to ask, do you need some help, my friend? Do you need some help? Do you need some help? Or to also ask, would you please help me with this? Would you please help me with this? And as we help one another, we obey the law of Christ. The law that we learned last week that says, love one another, just as Jesus has loved us. And so, our memory verse for today, as we help one another, is from Galatians chapter 6, verse 2. Galatians chapter 6, verse 2. What does it say? Did you get there with your Bible? Read with me.
Help to carry one another's burdens. And in this way, you will obey the law of Christ. Help to carry one another's burden. And in this way, you will obey the law of Christ. Our lessons today. Number one, we should help. We should help those in need. We should help those in need. We should be very quick to ask people if they need help. And number two, we should ask for help. Every time you feel that something is becoming very difficult, you are told to do something and you are not able to do it, always ask for help. Number three, helping one another is obedience to God. Helping one another is obedience to God. Helping one another is obedience to God. That is from Galatians. And finally, it is also what? A sacrifice to God. Helping one another is also what? A sacrifice that God is pleased with. It is also a sacrifice. And those are the things that the Bible has asked us to do. When you are unable to do something, you tell someone, please help me. When you find someone struggling to do something, you ask them, do you need some help? And then you offer to help them. What happens when they do not accept your help? Do you become sad and angry at them? You become, no. When they do not accept your help, you tell them, you could have used some help, but it is okay, I understand. And then you leave them, okay? And when they are done, after struggling, you teach them how to accept help from one another, all right? And when they can be able to do it, don't insist. If they can be able to carry their chair very easily, that means they don't need what? They don't need help. Even if you really want to help, it is okay. When someone does not need help, it is okay to let them do their work. But the Bible says that we should carry one another's burden. And this way, we fulfill the law of Christ. Again, our memory verse, Galatians chapter 6, verse 2, it says, help to carry one another's burden, and in this way, you will obey the law of Christ. Anytime you find someone in need of help, please offer them that help. Are we together? Great. And so ends our lesson. Do you remember what we have learned? That number one, we should help those who are in need. Number two, we should ask for help when we need it. Number three, helping one another is obedience to God. And number four, helping one another is a sacrifice to God. And these are the things that the Bible teaches us that we should do. Hello? Have you found someone in need? If you found someone who is unable to cross a small trench or a small ditch, and you are a big boy or a big girl and you can be able to cross, what do? You take their hand and you help them to cross. And when someone has helped us, do we remember what to do? We show our gratitude. How do we show gratitude? By saying, thank you for helping me with my homework. Thank you for helping me ride a bike. Thank you for helping me carry my chair. I appreciate. All right? Remember to always be grateful when people give their sacrifice and their obedience to God's law. All right? Great. And now, let us pray as we end our lesson. Hands together, we are praying. Father, in Jesus' name, we want to say thank you because you've helped us to understand how to help one another and how to accept help from those who can help us. Help us to go out and practice what we have learned. In Jesus' name we pray. Amen. Wonderful. Join us as we continue to sing a few more songs, and then we shall end our lesson.
My God is so big and so strong and so mighty. There's nothing my God cannot do. My God is so big and so strong and so mighty. There's nothing my God cannot do. My God is so big and so strong and so mighty. There's nothing my God cannot do. My God is so big and so strong and so mighty. There's nothing my God cannot do. In the beginning, God made everything. God simply spoke and the world came to be. He sent a flood and made everything new. He parted the sea and let his people walk through. He helped a boy bring a giant right down. Joshua marched the walls bound to the ground. These acts of power.
Cast your burdens.
Wonderful. So I hope you enjoyed the songs and you are happy. You are going out this week to offer help and to remember to love one another. All our burdens go to Christ. We remember to help one another and to love one another just like Jesus loves us. See you next time and bye-bye.
Melody in my heart to make it all. Oh, the love, 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 the love,